pepper, olive oil, the chopping board, the colander. Is a colander. Why have the things not come from Buckingham's? Merciful hems, the toast Melba. Have I made it? Have I made it? I seem to remember that I have. But if I have, where have I put it? At last,
one bunch of rosemary.
Rosemary, that's for remembrance. I remember when it grew wild in the hill.
One, a garlic.
Garlic, have you ever seen the flower?
No, but I've smelled the smell. Mushrooms and onions.
They should have been spring onions.
Spring's over.
Yes, spring is over.
And sick beautiful tomatoes.
Is that all?
No, sir. That'll be 7 and 4 pence.
Charge it to Lady Dunmow's account.
But Mr. Buckingham said I was to collect the money.
Mr. Buckingham, Mr. Buckingham, charge it to Lady Dunmow's account.
But Mr. Buckingham,
good evening.
Mr. Buckingham,
good evening.
Mr. Buckingham,
good evening.
Dear Mrs. Kneebone, a dream of an hour, which everyone my dear, this is Mrs. Kneebone, who has come for the evening to help.
Mrs. Kneebone, I hear that you have been kind enough to accept half a crown instead of your usual 3 shillings. 25 years ago, when I was envoy extraordinary and minister plenipotentiary to the Grand Duchy of Mnteblanco, I would gladly have paid you 3 and 6, 4 shillings, 4 and 6, 5 shillings. Envoy extraordinary 25 years ago in my salad days. In the summer of my time, when the regularly meet the select and the elite in a pink khaki with toast and tea. All we had to do was tell an attaché to ring a bell, and the staff would pour for 94. differently worded in the Times.
Mrs. Kneebone, they dine here tonight. Oh, my lady, a Grand Duchess and a gay, glamorous, brown-eyed, sophisticated bachelor to
A gypsy effect.
And sold the last of our saving certificates to buy you the prettiest dress. have not even opened. The prince likes ladies who are prettily dressed and prettily made up. The prince likes ladies who are
to the Gran
25 years ago. He was a quiet little boy. He was a quiet little boy who made far less noise than other little boys. He never needed toys.
Cold chair.
cherry soup. I will tell you when you have put on your makeup and your new gown. I will tell you when you look soigné. French, what we going to make? The national dish of the Grand Duchess's country. Tomate Mnteblanco.
Mnteblanco and tomatoes.
My husband will translate.
Thank you.
To the Grand Duchy of Mnteblanco 25 years ago. I never moved a muscle to get things done, prestissimo, in my day.
Today I have to bustle to get things done and keep a small house too.
Sir, No, sir, that was our goal.
That was our daily help, who comes once weekly. She is very weakly.
And not much help, papa. And not much help, papa.
She ruined the entry we had prepared in your honor, ma.
Ruinez surtout ce soir, or rajeunez espoir.
Philippe, oui, maman.
Present a little souvenir we have brought from Mnteblanco. It is pâté de foie gras. Now it makes no matter that your entrée is ruined. We will eat foie gras instead.
You only need to make toast
as your chef made toast.
I made it some hours ago, but I have forgotten where I put it. Where have I put it? Where have I put it?
No matter, no matter. I have often thought that with a good pâté, toast ruins the flavor. So now there is no more cooking to be done, and we have time for a promenade. I will inspect your grounds.
Our
grounds.
As far as the eye can see, ma'am, which on account of the high wall is 23 yards.
We do not think that you will find the experience fatiguing.
Thank you. permission, Lady Dunmow, I will continue to inspect your admirable kitchen. This way, ma'am, through the back door.
The back door?
Tomato ketchup? Then who was that swanny lady in evening dress who ran away with so loud a cry on my arrival?
She was a cousin, many times removed. You found her soignée?
Excessively. Far too excessively. I see hundreds of ladies like her every day of my tedious life. But has she gone?
Yes.
I'm very glad.
So am I. Would you care to try some of these cherries? I bottled them myself. I think they are better than my pickled walnuts.
They are my favorite fruit.
And mine.
They are not burned. Only they smell a little of smoke.
Then where did the smoke come from? Oh, my beloved father. What a sorry sight. What a sorry sight. He put them in the oven, which he forgot to light. When mother needed later, half an hour ago at most, it made the tomatoes, but then the toast.
What a happy sight, how beautiful and bright. Let's put them in the oven, which I myself will light. Now we
what
can serve them
sight.
Later.
What
an
happy sight! We see the tomatoes,
a bitter toast!
Prefer it.
I do wish it. Oh, so Maman, I have only known Susan for 15 minutes. 15 precious minutes.
It is not proper that persons of royal blood should know those to whom they become betrothed. Indeed, there would be very few royal betrothers if they did. 15 minutes is more than sufficient. The daughter of an English Earl and Countess is more than suitable.
What address shall we send a bill to?